Well, hello there, everybody. Today, I'm going to be an abusive landlord because we're going to be checking out a game called The Tenants. Now, in this one, it's kind of like Sims meets House Flipper. Basically, we have to renovate units and rent them out for a profit. So yeah, it sounds pretty awesome. We're going to start off a new game here and start on my landlord journey. All right, and here we are in Wonderville. For now, most of the city will remain inaccessible, but we'll unlock other districts over time. Ready to dive in? Click the slums district and meet me there. I mean, I guess you got to start somewhere, right? All right, for the slums, this looks pretty damn nice, I have to be honest. I mean, I guess we do have some actual slums over here. Anyways, I got to check my cell phone and I have a job coming in. I need someone to turn my old trailer into a proper living space. And this is where we're gonna start our life, guys. Look at this piece of crap. Okay, fantastic. So we wanna obviously clean it first, and we actually do have to clean it in this game, so we're gonna get in there and get a little bit dirty. All right, we have a 74% chance of restoring this. I'm assuming we have to buy these if we don't actually do it. It looks like luck is on my side today. Can we get them all? We're definitely gonna get them all because that gives me 100% right there. And now all we need to do is plaster up the giant crack in the wall. All right, so it's all cleaned up. Now there's some items that they request over here. So they want hardwood flooring, blue walls, a microwave, some TVs, some toilets, all that fun stuff. I don't know where I'm gonna fit a toilet in this, but okay. I guess we'll start off with the hardwood flooring. Are we gonna have hardwood under the shower? Of course we are. That seems like a great idea. They want blue walls. Blue walls you shall receive. Can I get like all fancy with these walls though? I'm probably gonna get docked for this, aren't I? Oh my god, this is so ugly. This actually worked. Okay, isn't it beautiful? I didn't even finish the walls, but everything costs money, so I want to get this way under budget. All right, let's start off with the bathroom. We're going to give them the full toilet. Again, we're going as cheap as we possibly can. There we go. Every house needs a stack of toilet paper by the toilet seat. I just love that somebody's going to be sitting in the living room kitchen area watching someone take a massive dookie. And the only other thing they want here is a TV, so we could either go for the $2,499 wall mounted, or we could just have a CRT, and you know I'm putting it in the bathroom area-ish. Oh, I love that there's no requirements on where you put these things. Oh, preferred furniture is DVDs as well. So I just realized we have a budget for this. It's not my cash though. This is the budget they allotted to me to furnish this place. So yeah, of course, if they want DVDs, I shall oblige. Ah, I love it when I see exclamation marks everywhere. I guess I can't walk to those probably, but at least they're going to be able to watch unlimited DVDs once they can find their way to the toilet. Oh, I actually can't finish the job because of the exclamation marks. God damn it, you wanted DVDs? I'm just listening to you. I also forgot the microwave, so we can conveniently place it on the ground by the fridge. Yeah, I did definitely live in this trailer. A job well done, if I do say so myself. Now that you finished your first official job, I'll let you in on a secret. Your aunt and my dear wife left you this unit. It's a perfect opportunity to get your landlord career started, but the apartment will require some upfront work before we can rent it out. Look at this, my first actual building. Can you smell the drugs? Because I sure as hell can. Oh god, we're right by the slums. All right, so there goes all my money. I gotta connect electricity to it. And I'm assuming I have to do all the rest as well as we earn some money here because we're back down to $500 cash. Ah, we have a review already. It looks like they seem to be happy except with the decor. Oh, actually, there's no issues. The category was ignored. Did you not like the DVDs? That's decor to me. Drae actually knows how to renovate. Thank you, Uncle Steve. Uncle Steve knows what's up. All right, well, let's go get another happy customer. Taylor Sparks, I just like your name. I'm not even gonna read it. Let's just accept it. And away we... Oh, it's across the street. But goddamn, this is a nice place. I'm assuming I just need to furnish this room. So yeah, we have this perfectly furnished apartment building with, for whatever reason, no bathroom at all. Well, Dre's on the job and he'll build you the perfect bathroom. Every bathroom needs checkered flooring. It's just the rules. And you know what's gonna go well with squares? Triangles. Why the hell is there a shower curtain for the door? You know what? I kind of love it. Let's keep it. You know what? We have a budget of $3,000, so it's probably dumb to buy this tub. But god damn it, I want it. Wait, do we need to have both sides? All right, we're just gonna have a tub in this room and that's it. Why don't we have toilet rolls above the toilets? That's just a good idea for space. Oh, God damn it. I didn't realize that I had a specific floor that they wanted, stone or laminate, and we need yellow or red. Well, the freaking customer's always right, isn't he? Let's get this really ugly paper because I'm actually mad at the customer now, but it actually kind of looks awesome. And let's get this fake wood flooring. Oh my God, this... This room looks fitting for this house, though. Everything is brown. I didn't even notice till now. And the preferred furniture is a wall clock, so I'm hoping an ancient grandfather clock's good. It actually feels fitting in this room. There, that wasn't the right clock. I'm mad once again, so I'm going to make them spend their whole budget on very cheap wall clocks. This is looking like an art installment at this point. Who needs bathroom mirrors when you have time on your hands? There we go. And... 60% of my budget on clocks, the rest on actual furniture. A job well done once again. And there we go. Hopefully another happy customer. Oh, she going to check it out? Do you see? Oh, yeah, she's liking the clocks. She is. Wait, she's confused by the clocks. I'm actually surprised. It seems like they actually know what's going on. She just keeps looking at the clocks. You asked for a clock. I'm just listening. Oh, she's writing a bad review, isn't she? Oh, I got new items for that. Yay, a toaster, as well as a lot of other beige things. Well, there we go. Another happy customer. I'll take 4 stars. Kind of a weird first impression, though. I guess I'm gonna have to work on that skill. Okay, I don't know what the hell a wall plant is. All I have is big plants. What the hell is a wall plant? You want a Christmas tree? Here. Does this count? Oh, you're keeping it anyways. Oh, there actually is wall plants. There we go. We'll throw this right above the toaster so it catches fire, hopefully. Then they'll have to get another renovation. I'm just thinking ahead, ladies and gentlemen. What's up with your wall fetish here? What, wall lamps now? All right, here, we'll put this by the plant as well, so hopefully it catches fire more. And you know what? I still have a 2K budget left, so we'll just throw a TV. You know what? Let's just put it on this wall because it fits very well. It's very pleasing. All right, this one I actually kind of tried in, and it kind of worked out. Just ignore the Christmas tree, as well as the fact that I didn't even notice until now I painted the walls over here, but they won't care. Drae wasn't exceptional. What the hell, man? I'm gonna burn your place down. I mean, he did give me some of the best reviews yet, but you can't say I'm not exceptional when I'm putting Christmas trees in your kitchen. Oh, we have an esports player looking for a bedroom designer. Well, I am no esports player, but I'm a video game idiot. So here, let's get it done, man. You know what? For an esports player, I thought there'd be, you know, a PC or something here. No, it's just oddly basic, except for the oddly purple kitchen. Also, can you have enough cringy slogans on your walls? Be brave, what? Dream big? Did you smile today? It's time to shine. This is someone who's clearly depressed. Dude, there's more. I keep finding them. This is only so big of a house, but there's not enough space for more. Only the best for my esports pro. A secondhand mattress on wood. Oh, Jesus, the anime figures. I was gonna get a crap load of them. Holy Jesus. I mean, I know these things are expensive, but I'm gonna have to sell some stuff, my dude. There we go. I guess you're only getting... Oh my God! I can see why it's expensive now. I don't want to know what you're doing with this thing. I can't even fit it in your freaking room. I kind of want to get you the good anime figure here, but I feel like your cringy slogans are more important for you at least. I mean... Oh, damn it. No, I didn't want to sell the freaking game console. You only get part of what you sell back. Now, I only needed one game, so we're gonna sell that too. At this point, I have enough for the anime chick, so at the bare minimum, he's gonna be happy about that. He'll be really happy about that. I just got an achievement called Senpai. Are you freaking serious? Okay, I need to get $100 somewhere. I think we're gonna have to downgrade your TV. The anime figure cost me everything. Unfortunately, the customer's always right, so we're gonna sell the really expensive TV. And yeah, we'll just put his nice flat screen on the floor. I mean, I did have this a lot nicer, but your anime chick was really expensive. Can't deliver job unless requirements are met. What did I miss? Game? There's a game right here! What the? Is this the wrong game? What do you want from me? All right, let's just search game. I mean, is it this one then? Dino Hop? Is it not the right esports game for you? Oh, that's not it either. Do you want a checkerboard? I mean, I have some money now. What the hell is a game? In my frustrations, it somehow worked out. So I think the game was in the way of the anime figure. Why you need to go close to the anime figure? I don't want to know. But you have fun. It's your bedroom after all. There we go. That was a stressful one. There's the esports lad himself. Oh, he's liking his poster already. Oh, he loves it. Dude, I know my customer so well. He goes right, whoa, easy now. He goes right for the slogan posters. Oh, he's one of those customers. He wasn't happy. I might not have expected too much, but I guess this new look of the flat is all right. I'm sorry you have a freaking anime figure half the size of your room. What do you want from me? It looked way better until I got that. Well, the good news is we can install our heating now. So that's exciting. $6,000 well spent. That was $6,000 for one of those radiator heaters. Are you serious? First, we need to clean this place up. Send me in and let's get started. All right, old man. Clean up for me. Looks like we have everything to get our first place done so I can build my own unit now to rent out. So I don't want that wall. I don't want that wall. Should we just have a giant open concept? The better the interior design, the wealthier tenants will want to live in your place. Okay, so that's a good point. I was gonna, you know, go crazy with this thing. But it might make sense considering it's my own place to actually do this right. Well, it pains me to do this, but this is clearly an evil foosball machine, so I need the money right now. I kind of went overboard with the kitchen. I bought some really good appliances. Hopefully they like that. We're gonna have the world's smallest bedroom, but that's okay because we have a corner bed. It's just cozy. That's what they say when, you know, it's really freaking small and they just don't want to admit it, right? It actually kind of does look cozy, though. I should probably get a toilet. That would be smart. This is the bathroom, by the way. Don't ask why the floor is blue. I just felt like it was right. Oh god, I only have $231 left. I was gonna do a shower. We might need to wait for that. You might need to go stinky, because yeah, we basically have enough money for a toilet right now, and that's it. But I guess that's all they want? Ah, man, it was gonna be such a nice house, but I ran out of money. I could go get a job, but I just want to put this on the market. All right, so let's go to the open house panel and start right now. On an open house day, people interested in your rental will come by to check out the apartment out. This is actually pretty cool. All right, let's do it. Yeah, we're just going to do a free one. It's not like I can afford anything anyways. And, yeah, let's see if we can get somebody in here. Oh, she seems to be liking it. That's good. Go check out the kitchen. That's where all the money is. I just realized there's, like, no TV or anything. It's just in a depressing sofa over here. But hey, I have to remember, it's our first unit, and we gotta start somewhere. Oh, I gotta actually, negotiate. You could do history checks? Like, this is serious. All right, let's see if we can do this. Select a rent price. All right, I want to get a profit of $2,000. Hopefully this housing market is crazy. Let's make an offer here. $3,000. Ooh, hey, if I wasn't greedy, I'd accept that. $3,000, damn it. Oh god, she went back. She's one of those ladies. I'm gonna go forward then. This is not how it works. Oh god. No, can I get a new lady? I'm just gonna go until she rejects my offer. Can't make any new offers. Oh my god, wait, am I stuck with her? I seriously can't ask her to leave, so I feel like with this first one, they're making me do it. You know what? Before I screw it up anymore, I still get a good profit. Let's just accept. I royally screwed that up. I hope I can fire her. Is that how it works? Oh, we get elite contracts now where we can go to fancy pants places. I'm actually intrigued. Okay, looks like my tenant's happy. She got a really good deal, and she's on her phone already. That feels fitting. Oh, she's messaging me. I'm awfully glad we've been connected by our housing agreement. For now, you'll be able to contact me at this number, Cindy Bruce. Are you trying to hit on me, Cindy? Ah, there we go. Looking for some scrawny architect to make me find cabin for me mates. Holy Jesus, we get 13 grand and a payment of 4,400. Let's go see this fancy pants place. I'm excited. And away we go. Oh my god, it's a freaking boat. What the hell do you want, Cindy? Oh my god, what did you do? Okay, Cindy, I'm sorry. I understand you just came here. I have better things to do. Let's be honest here. Let's just pretend we're not being invaded by cockroaches right now. Maybe they'll just go away. Or you know what? Maybe they'll eat Cindy so I can get a better deal on my renovation. All right, and here we go. Our first fancy pants elite contract. They're still telling me about the cockroaches. I'm just gonna avoid it, you know? That's generally how problems are solved. So we want hammocks, barrels, and boat decorations, and that's literally it. All right, cool. Rich people are weird, man. Like, what the hell is this room? Let's just have four hammocks in a room when, you know, we're on a boat. They would be perfect outside, but no, I want a hammock room, damn it. Cindy seems a little mad, guys. Did she fix it for me? We'll find out in a little bit. I'm still working on this weird room. All right, and here's your tables of pirate treasure or whatever the hell you're doing in this weird room. Life on a boat? Yeah, we'll throw that up there. We have money to spend. This might be the worst room yet. And it's the rich guy's house. Oh yeah, I forgot. These people always want specific walls and whatnot. Honestly, my design looked way better, but hey, you do you, man. Just this whole game loves brown, clearly. All right, well, that's what they wanted, and the customer's always right, so here's your job.
He's a freaking pirate. He's got a stupid parrot.
Babysitting? I didn't even read that, but I can babysit. Do people not know who I am? All right, well, fake rich pirate seems to be enjoying his pirate room, so that's fantastic. I'm just gonna leave this place. I should probably go check on my,
my place. She's still there. They didn't kill Cindy yet.
Oh, Cindy, you dealt with it. See, that's the thing, guys. I told you, if you avoid problems, they just solve themselves. Oh man, Jenna. It's like Drae replaced the door with a portal to a different world. Astonishing. It's better than I could have imagined. Oh, the rich people love me. That's the important part. All right, let's go babysit a child. Oh, we're looking after tenants. I don't know why I thought I'd be a babysitter, but I'm cool with that too. Good day, Drae. Bethany, who, what? Hope this message finds you well. I was supposed to contact you as you seem to be the new person in charge. I really like my landlord, so no pressure. Have a nice day. Thank you, Bethany. Oh God, I have bills I have to pay? All right, pay them all. There we go. Open house jobs unlocked. Okay, there's so many jobs in this game. This is actually a remarkable game, guys. I will say that. It's not just simply, you know, renovate, upgrade, and rent out. There's so many different things you can do. New marketing options for house days. Uh-oh. Well, you know what we do when this happens? We're just gonna go away and pretend it doesn't exist again. Oh, you know what? Cindy's fighting back. She hasn't paid me. Let's remind her politely as rats are invading. I've got a pack of rats in my flat. Any moment now, they'll start riding bikes in here. And then I'm just like, yeah, cool. Pay me. I've got no money. Well, what the hell do I do now? I can't demand payment yet. I guess I have to wait a certain amount of time. Let's try and get on our right side. Let's send Uncle over because $1,600 is way too much money for me. Go get him, Uncle. Get. What am I supposed to do? Have I actually got to catch them? Oh, set trap. Oh, this is way better than spending $1,600. There you go. I don't know why I'm doing this. She's not even paying her rent right now. Then again, I kind of deserved it. Let's be honest here. All right, Cindy, you better pay me after this. I swear to God, I had to get my uncle here. He's old. He's dying. Oh God, what's going on? Hello, there's a problem in my electronic equipment. Could you do something about that? You know what I'm doing. Go over there, uncle. Oh, Jesus Christ. Uncle, quick. I don't know if I like these babysitting jobs. All right, there we go. Ah, now we can demand payment. There we go. Oh my God, that's a little aggressive. I don't know if that's legal. I'm sorry, I'll get to it right away. Oh, now I feel bad. I thought we were gonna fight and stuff. Okay, well, she paid, so we're even again. All right, guys, I think we're gonna wrap up this episode of The Tenants here. I hope you guys enjoyed this. It's oddly a great little simulation game. I love the whole people management aspect of it, where people won't pay rent. We have to do things like deal with cockroaches and everything as we go and get bigger and better units. So let me know if you guys want to see more of this. And yeah, as always, guys, thanks for watching and liking. I'll see you in the next one.